Hi everyone, welcome to Every Day, your daily stop for virtual reality content. My name is Dee, and today, on the Oculus Rift Development Kit 2, we will be checking out some high-resolution 360-degree videos. These are recorded using real cameras in the real world. They record scenes that completely surround you on every side, so you can look all around inside them as the video is playing. And because the videos are in 4K resolution, they'll actually have enough pixels so that in the DK2 you can look around and have full detail on the DK2's display. So if you work it out, so the DK2's display is 1920 by 1080. And the horizontal field of view is about 90 to 100 degrees, depending on various factors. And so that means that the degrees for each... the pixels per degree. So for each degree of your field of vision, there's about 10 pixels per degree, or maybe 11. And in order to fill up, in order to match that with a video that completely surrounds you 360 degrees, you need 10 or 11 times 360, which gets you about 4K resolution. So to have full resolution on DK2, you need to have 4K video. And to have full resolution on the consumer version of the Rift, you're going to need something like, it's 2560 pixels wide and about the same field of view. So you're going to need about 50% more pixels wide. So you're going to need like a 6,000 pixel wide video. So I don't know if we have the technology for that yet, but we'll have to work it out when the release version of the Consumer Rift comes around. Like right now, it's even hard to encode a video with that kind of resolution. Speaking of video, this video you're looking at of me against my green screen is actually recorded today using the Samsung Galaxy Note 4, the same smartphone that is going to go into the Gear VR, mobile VR device. It has a mode to record, they call it smooth video. It's actually a 1080p 60 frames per second recording mode. And that works out well since YouTube supports 60 frames a second now, and I am recording the footage of the application itself at 60 frames a second, so I'll be able to composite that all together. Gear VR, speaking of Gear VR, is coming out tomorrow. It has been officially announced it's going to go up for sale. Well, maybe not officially, but it has been leaked. And there are some very good sources that say it is coming out tomorrow, which is Monday. So those of you looking forward to it, be ready to pounce on that when it goes up for pre-orders on Samsung's website. Now, without further ado, I'm going to be playing these inside a virtual desktop. Virtual desktop is an application that simulates, that takes your monitor and sticks it inside a virtual space so you can look at your monitor on a big virtual screen in front of you and do all the things you normally do on your monitor. I visited this application before in an earlier video, and in that video, it was an earlier version of the software, and they've made a lot of very cool improvements that I want to show you while I am doing this. So I will definitely do that. Without further ado, let's jump into virtual desktop and watch some 360 videos. Let's go. All right, here we are inside the very latest version of virtual desktop. Now, this version of virtual desktop has also been integrated with the very latest Oculus SDK, version 0.4.4. And version 0.44 is pretty incredible. The latency is very, very low. You can see in this particular app, I'm registering a latency of 25.7 milliseconds, but it is being fully corrected by the time warp. And so when I nod my head briskly like this as fast as I can barely feel, like I can't even feel like the world. Normally, if I did that in past versions of the SDK, I would feel the world kind of dragging behind a little bit as I move my head fast up and down. But in this app, it feels totally solid. It feels fine, and that is amazing. They've made so many great leaps, improvements in how they handle latency in the Rift, and it's really gotten to the point where it's hard to detect that there's any latency at all, which is incredible considering where they started out from with, you know, like 40 or 50 milliseconds on DK1. Anyway, so this is, you can see my OBS window here. I'm going to minimize that so it's not so distracting. We got kind of the infinite regression effect going on in there. All right. So This is the virtual desktop settings. You can access it by clicking on the eye in your system tray. And it has a bunch of cool settings. I am currently in curved mode. Now, curved mode used to like move the screen around as you look from side to side. It doesn't do that anymore. The screen is fixed in place, and that's a big improvement. And I really like how it's curved so that kind of the edges of the screen are as clearly visible as the center of the screen. If I uncheck curved, I can show you what it looks like normally. I'm going to move it a bit farther. So at this size, so 100% size, I can read the text in front of me very clearly. But towards the edge of the screen, like I can't read that tab in the upper left very well. Just kind of barely read. It says Ogil's Rift. And I can't read the time down in the lower right corner. So because those are farther away and things that are farther away in the Rift are represented using less pixels, they get harder to read. So the curved screen fixes that. So now I can clearly read the time in the corner. I can clearly read Oculus Rift in the top left, and I can read the screen in front of me. And if I increase the screen size a bit, they become even clearer. So another big improvement, I don't recall if this was in the old version, but it has high quality distortion. And what that means is that every pixel, so you know how it goes, takes the original flat screen and it barrel distorts it, it squeezes it in, and that allows it to fit all the content on the Rift screen and also makes it so that the distortion that's done by the lenses when the light passes through them is undone so that they cancel each other out. So high quality distortion means that each pixel in the distorted image is based on many pixels from the original rendered image. And that makes it much, much easier to read text. So if I turn it off, so there's kind of an aliasing or crawling effect around text that's very distracting, or around those diagonal lines in that calendar there. It's easier for me to see because it's magnified for me, but there's definitely a lot of aliasing, a lot of crawling. Text is harder to read and looks uglier. So I'm going to turn that right back on, and it's much nicer now. So you're discouraged from moving your head when this is low quality distortion because it just looks bad, but it looks much better with it on. Anyway, so these are the side-by-side options. So I'm going to explain how this works before I get to that. So transparent, this is so cool. I just want to show this really quickly. So my desktop is black. There's nothing on it, but if I turn on transparent, now my desktop is non-existent. So this is not just a wallpaper. This is like I'm looking behind and seeing the galaxy in the distance. My desktop has vanished from the universe. And if I open, say, a terminal window, my terminal window is also a window into the great void of the universe. And that is very, very cool. So I can do like this. I can type, say, directory. I can see the galaxy moving behind the text. It's like it's printed on a pane of glass. That is super, super cool. I really like that effect, and it makes me wonder what other kind of cool things we'll be able to do with embedding PC displays inside of cool environments. And speaking of cool environments, so you can still do the black if you really want to, if you don't want any distractions. It has several cool space scenes that you can try. Ooh, whoa, there's a planet. Sweet. Okay. And what else is there? This is the very new home theater environment. And in this environment, the screen has a fixed size and a fixed setting. But this is just a great environment for watching any kind of movie because you can just bring it up on the screen and I'll show you exactly what it does. So I'm gonna pick some random episode of Game of Thrones I was watching on here earlier. So, how about the first episode? There we go. I'm gonna use Windows Media Player. There's a little issue right now where if I try and watch something in VLC, it only shows the upper left part of the video. I don't know why it does that, but it's not a big deal. I will watch in Windows Media Player. Here it is. I'm going to turn on my subtitles. Subtitles. English. And now I'm going to stop moving my mouse and the lights will go down. The room is dimming for me. You can see I'm in this super comfortable chair. And behind me, I think that's where like the projector is or something. And there's another row of seats behind me. There's a door over there. There's these cool light sconces in the wall. Looks like those are rangers leaving the wall. And yeah, this is just a really comfortable, nice environment. Like, if you don't have a good home theater set up at home, this, like, they size the screen just right, so it feels about, I want to say about 90 degrees of your vision, 80 to 90 degrees, which is a very nice size. You get plenty of detail without having to look around too much. I do still wish that was configurable so that you could, like, maybe move your chair forwards and backwards to adjust your field of view, something like that. But yeah, I love this environment. It feels great. It looks great. And the screen fits inside it perfectly. The frame rate is really great just watching stuff. So I'm very happy with this environment. Let's get out of here and back into space. Back in space now. And I'm going to close out of this. And so as before, you can start games directly from Virtual Desktop and you will be plopped directly into the world of the game and it'll surround you on all sides. One thing you have to watch out for, there is this full screen option. Full screen improves performance when you're just using Virtual Desktop as a desktop like this. But if you are going to play one of these full screen Rift games, you actually have to uncheck this first because otherwise it won't work. All right. Now it's time for the 360 video player. I'm going to play two videos today. The first one is going to be a monoscopic 360 video that I like a lot that has 4K resolution. It will be called The Alien Desert. You can get this in 4K resolution directly from Oculus Share. I will include a link in the description. Make sure that you click the 4K link in the description and it'll give you a zip file. The MP4 file will be inside that. Do not download using the download link. That will give you the low resolution version. All right, let's go. Let's go. The Alien Desert. I am ready. All right. Here we are. Inside the alien sky. The Alien Desert. And it has all this time-lapse video that goes on in it. You can see the sky just moving by super fast. There's these huge arcing rocks going right over your head. I love how this video does these things where they have things going arching over your head and you can follow them with your eye. Like this tree here, I can follow my head going up and down the tree. And it really just forces you to really look around and take advantage of this 360 environment. And it's a beautiful film. There's so many beautiful scenes in it. Just watching as that starry sky and all the stuff going on the ground and the lights going by. Are those planes? What were those soaring through the sky there? And there's these thorny exotic looking plants. I'm not sure where this is taken. I feel like it might be Australia, but it might be some other place. I actually have no idea. You can see that below you, there's like this reflecting pool all the time. I'm pretty sure this is rendered in software because it doesn't look like a natural reflecting pool that I've ever seen. And I think they do that so that they don't have to worry about capturing the lower half of the frame. They only have to worry about capturing upwards. I believe they have like a 180 degree camera that captures upwards, and that's how they're doing this. And it works out really nicely because, I'm just guessing how they're doing this based on what it looks like, but it works out nicely. But, ooh, look at that sun shining through those branches. This is pretty, and everything's getting dark. Oh, wow. Okay, like I was saying, I think it works out really well because there's no visible seams in the scene as you look around. Unlike some of the other videos I've seen where they had to stitch multiple cameras together, they're either doing a really good job of stitching or they're just using a single lens here because I don't see any artifacts between, any kind of stitching artifacts, any kind of weird, like, fuzzy boundaries between, ooh, look at that writing. And the texture shows up as the light falls on it. Is that like Aboriginal writing or I don't even know. And the clouds racing past and the tree, you can see the tree blowing in the wind super fast. And you gotta be careful not to lean too much when you're watching a 360 video, because the positional tracking does not actually work that well. Because they didn't record depth information when they were taking the video, so there's just no way to usefully do positional tracking. Oh, I love this video. Oh my gosh, looks so much. And you can see the bark coming off that tree in so much detail. Like, I've never seen a 360 video before with this level of detail. It's just incredible. You can see all the individual leaves. You can see in the distance the details of those clouds. It is at the full resolution of DK2. And seeing the stars in the sky, you can really see it does such a great job at this 4K resolution of taking advantage of the DK2 and its full detail ability. And I can't imagine now what 6K videos are going to look like on the Oculus Rift consumer version, because they'll have even more detail and it'll start to look more and more realistic. That was already pretty damn realistic. It was amazing. All right. So that was the Alien Desert, and this is my new go-to video. Seriously, this, in terms of 360 video on the Rift in virtual reality, this is my new go-to experience. It is amazing. It is incredibly detailed, and even though it is monoscopic with both eyes seeing the same view, I really think it's compelling and beautiful, and I love everything about it. But for those of you who want to see what does a stereoscopic experience, that is a 360 video, look like, where you can actually have your eyes see different images and use that to perceive depth, I'm going to show you Kangaroo Island. I've processed this video to make it play in virtual desktop. I included a link to my processed version in the description, and this processing did reduce the resolution, so this is not going to be full 4K resolution. It's going to be half that, but it is stereoscopic. I'm going to click on side by side, and I'm ready to go. Experience Kangaroo Island. Let's go. We're on the boat. We're on the boat to the island. And you can look at this lever here. It looks super close by that stereoscopic depth. There's the island in the distance. You can see that atoll over there that we're just starting to get inside. Oh, I forgot I can't lean. There's some big jagged rocks. You can see some rocks right at my feet here. Now this one has some very clearly visible seams. There's like a seam here. There's a seam there. And especially with stereoscopy, those seams jump out at you, because there's usually a break in depth at that point as well. So it works best in scenes where the seams are not in bad places, like in the middle of a rock. You can see our footsteps leading up to the camera. You can see the shadow of the camera. Looks like it's a pretty small rig they're using. I like this scene a lot. There's like a person back there. You can see them moving around a bit. I like these chairs. These chairs are not fault. There's no seams going through them, so they look really nice. This one has a seam going through it. But yeah, they look like they're super close. I like those chairs. Here we are hanging out on the rocks down at the shore. That big hill behind us. I wonder how they got here. They must have followed that path. Here I am. I think I'm now out on this part, which is like surrounded by the ocean on three sides. There's like a pier over there in the distance. You can see that grass right in front of me kind of waving in the wind. And that's it. That's Kangaroo Island. And I really enjoy that video. It's a good example. It's probably the only example that's ever been created of stereoscopic 360 video. And as you can see, there's basically no way right now for them to make stereoscopic 360 video that doesn't have visible seams in it, and that is an issue. They're working on that technology, and I'm hoping in the future it's going to get better. But for now, I actually tend to prefer the monoscopic experiences like the Alien Desert that avoid those seams, because those can really detract from the experience. Now, before we close out, I want to show you a few more options here, the side-by-side options, and these are cool. So first of all, I'm going to show you some of the simpler ones. So say that I go to one of my old videos that I made, like Zelda Wind Waker. and I go to my gameplay video. I'm going to open this up in Windows Media Player. So this was just gameplay I recorded with OBS. And now if I go full screen, so I'm going to go full screen and then I'm going to hit F8. Let's go. And I'm going to hit play. And now I am seeing this video precisely as I originally saw the gameplay while playing the game. So there's no distortion, there's no chromatic aberration because I'm using my directly captured video here. And I can just watch it back in Virtual Desktop. So this is really cool if you play VR games on the Rift and you want to just record them and then watch your gameplay again later and have the exact same experience from the same point of view. You can do that with your F8 key in Virtual Desktop, the Send to Rift option. Oops, I'm going to hit F8 to get out of this. There we go. You can do to Rift plus distortion, which will also do the distortion. And that's appropriate in cases where the video is a normal side-by-side video. So say that I had actually one of my unwarped videos. So I'm going to go, where's my unwarped video here? Gameplay unwarped. Let's use this one. So if you have an unwarped side-by-side video, like this one, then I can use my F9 key. The F9 key will do the distortion along with the chromatic aberration correction and allow me to watch the scene as I originally saw it using unwarped video. Just like that. And this works quite well. You can also use this mode with side-by-side like films and stuff. It will cause the film to fill your entire vision and you will not be able to look around. Gotta hit F9. And you will not be able to look around inside the film, so it's not the best experience, but it is interesting that you can do that. So for example, if I go here and I open up, say, The Hobbit, and I skip to some middle part, and say I now hit F9, I'd have no head tracking, so it's stuck to my face, but it is filling the rift, so just corner to corner on the rift is this movie. It's exactly filling it. But that's not usually what you want to do with a film. What you probably want to do with a film is actually to use one of these other modes. So in this case, this is an anamorphic film. That means that the left and the right views are both 16:9 aspect ratio, but they squish them by a factor of 2 horizontally to make them both fit into this 1920:1080 video. And so that means it's anamorphic. So I want F7, the on-screen anamorphic option. So I'm going to go full screen. I'm going to hit F7. I'm looking through my nose hole to see the function keys on my keyboard because blind typing function keys is not much fun. And there we go. Now we're watching the video on our virtual curved screen in stereoscopic 3D. This is the 3D version of The Hobbit, and it is working very nicely. And you can pause at any point and just check out the stereoscopic 3D. Gonna hit F7, get back into normal mode. And you can adjust your screen to fill as much or as little of your vision as you want. If I'm watching a film, I usually set it to more like 80 or 85. So I'm gonna go back into that, hit F7 again. It's kind of cool how when you have it set to transparent mode, it actually, the bars at the top and bottom of the screen are transparent, so you can see the space behind them. So yeah, I like this angle of view. Some people like it to take up somewhat less, but I can see quite a lot of detail in the movie at this angle of view. I like this. Gonna get out. F7. There we go. And finally, F6 is for content that is not anamorphic, not squished. So if I were to use F6 on this video, the video would become very tall because because it is squished like that. But if I find another image that's not squished, so say I'm looking at this NASA sun in 3D. So I'm going to zoom it a bit. There we go. Looks about right. And Now let me zoom in a little bit more, a little bit more. And now I'm going to hit F6. There we go. There is. So this was based on some pictures of the sun taken by satellites. The satellites were in different parts of Earth's orbit. And so they were able to construct this 3D stereoscopic image of the sun, which is very, very cool. And yeah, that's NASA studying the sun in 3D. So, and because this image was not squished, I had to hit F6 instead of F7. If I hit F7, I would get this oval-shaped sun. That's not what the sun looks like. The sun is not an egg. So yeah, that is all the cool new features of Virtual Desktop. I am so excited that this keeps developing. If I had to comment on things I might want to see improved, so I want to see this full screen, like this full screen mode. You normally have to turn it off if you go into an application, because otherwise it won't work. I would like it to just do that automatically for me, because I like to keep full screen on because it really improves performance for me in Virtual Desktop, makes everything very smooth. But you can't have it when you're running applications from your Games tab. So I don't like having to do that manually every time. And I love the home theater environment. It really shows the potential that you can just put anything you can put up on your screen. You can watch Netflix, you can watch Hulu, you can watch YouTube. You can watch, you know, videos with your video player. You can watch a camera stream. You can watch anything on here, anything. And being able to do that in your home, in this cool home theater environment, is just so much potential. And what I want to see is just more environments like this. This environment's super cool. I want to see more of them. I want to see it be like, maybe you could be able to plug in environments that other people develop as like little plugins. So you could have like a forest environment, a mountaintop environment. You could be on a space station orbiting the Earth. You could like turn to your left, look out the window, see the Earth down below. You could like be on a boat at sea. There's just all kinds of cool places you could be while you are watching your videos or doing stuff on your virtual computer. So, I mean, being out in the universe is very cool. And floating in the middle of nothingness, I'm a fan. And it's very efficient for them to do a simple skybox like this. But I'm eager to see more environments. So that is all for today. Let me know any other demos that you want to see me play. And let me know any questions you have about this software. Oh, that's cool how I'm looking around these bubbles and looking through the black part. By the way, SDK 0.4.4 has eliminated the fuzzy boundaries at the edge of each of the screen views. They had that there for a while to make the edges of the views less obvious, but I was actually not a big fan of them. I'm glad they're gone because it maximizes the field of view, and they didn't really... The sharp edges aren't really visible to me at my eye relief setting. So I'm very happy with this. Anyway, so everything is spectacular. 0.4.4 is great. The latency is great. The vignette that they removed is great. The 360 video hardware accelerated playing is great. The home theater is a great environment to sit in and just watch videos. I love everything about this new version of Virtual Desktop. And if you have not checked it out by now, you need to go and do it, because this is just a whole new way of interacting with things. And it will really set a model for how things are going to look in the future. So I will see you guys next time. And let me know any thoughts that you have. Everybody have a great every day.